I gave the position to Sabino Brunello to solve, telling him it was special. However, he did not find anything special about it, but rather emphasized the weakness of the b6/c5/d6 constellation. Knight f3 d2. In order to take advantage of the weak squares, Sabino transfers the most inactive piece towards squares where it can control two of them, either e4, c5/d6, or c4, b6/d6. the black position, and an obvious weakness on d5 in the white position. The weakness of the constellation b6/c5/d6 is, in my opinion, rather obvious, but of course there is also the slight weakening of the black kingside with the h7/h6 advance. I seriously doubt whether I would have believed the latter to be more important before I saw this game, but reading de Koyen's variations, the words below are mine, the lines his, in New in Chess magazine actually convinced me that this was the case. Queen c2 c1. De Koyen was full of praise for this move. The idea is quite stunning. White spends time rearranging his queen and light squared bishop to give the duo a bit more bite. As things transpire in the game, it seems as if black cannot get his defense organized in time. b6 captures c5. Bishop d3 b1. Bishop e7 f6. Queen c1 c2. g7 g6. Might look like a natural way to defend against the threat of mate. But once again we see the effect of the slight weakening of the kingside by the initial advance of the h-pawn. The e6/f7/g6 constellation sorely lacks the support of the h-pawn. White strikes with Rook e1 captures e6. When black's variations do not work, he cannot accept the sacrifice as white brings in reinforcements after the initial checks. As always, the concept of evolution/revolution/evolution must be understood in order to play attacking chess, with nh4 g6. So, if black is not to end up with a pawn less, he needs to try. Rook e1 takes on e6. When black's various options do not work, he cannot accept the sacrifice as white brings in reinforcements after the initial checks. As always, the concept of evolution/revolution/evolution must be understood in order to play attacking chess, with nh4 g6. So, if black is not to end up with a pawn less, he needs to try. c5 captures d4. Here white establishes his superiority with Bishop a3 d6. Bishop a3 d6. Queen b8 a7. Knight f3 takes on d4. Rook d8 e8. White still has a considerable advantage with the game move, but as De Koyen points out, White had a convincing and direct way to end the game. G2 G4. Rook F5 G5. Queen C2 H7. King G8 F8. Bishop B1 F5. E6 takes on F5. Rook E1 captures E7. Rook E1 captures E7. In addition, engines also point out the more brutal and less intuitive. Rook E1 captures E6. F7 takes on E6. Queen C2 E2. Black seems unable to defend himself, even with an extra rook, the position of the pieces on the queenside is too poor. A possible line is King G8 F8. Queen E2 captures E6. Rook F5 G5. Bishop A3 captures C5. Bishop E7 captures C5. Queen E6 captures F6. King F8 G8. Queen F6 E6. King G8 F8. D4 captures C5. And there is no real defense against the rook coming into D7. In the game, Black had some chances to defend a little better, for example by putting the king on F8 rather than H8. H2 H4. King G8 H8. H2 H4. King G8 H8. Queen C2 E2. Bishop B7 A6. Queen E2 E3. Rook F5 H5. Bishop A3 captures C5. Bishop E7 captures C5. D4 captures C5. D4 captures C5. Queen A7 E7. Queen E3 E4. F6 F5. Queen E4 E5. King H8 G8. G2 G3. Queen A7 captures C5. Queen E3 F3. King H8 G7. Queen F3 G4. King G7 H8. Rook D1 D7. Rook C8 G8. Queen G4 F3. Rook H5 E5. Queen F3 captures F6.